joins us live again from Melbourne with a very special guest from the Lego exhibition.
You.
Libby, is it true this guest goes by the name of the Brickman?
It is. It is. This is the Brickman, Ryan McNaught. Would you make him welcome to Studio 10? Now, Ryan is responsible for all sorts of amazing creations. For instance, Ryan, tell us about this.
This is the Lego Love Boat. This is a quarter of a million Lego bricks and took me over 6 months to put together. Oh. And like all good 80s retro things, it's got every guest star that was ever on board.
Oh. Well, that just sounds completely bizarre. And is your marriage still intact after that exercise?
Absolutely. I'm very lucky to have a good wife.
Well, you are incredibly lucky. Where do you start with something like that?
Like any good thing, it's about research. So I had to watch lots of tacky 80s episodes of the Love Boat. So, yeah, lots of Captain Stubing.
Yeah, but I just want to know, if you start with that, which is like one brick.
You bet. Right, just like that one. Right, exactly that one.
And do you use instructions?
Absolutely not. That's cheating.
So you make up the instructions?
Yep, that's right. So we sit down and do a lot of sketches, drawings, all of that kind of stuff first and go from there.
How does a man like you get this job to be one of, well, the only certified Lego professional in the Southern Hemisphere? He was quite normal before he got into this.
Very lucky, right place at the right time. I used to be in IT all those years ago, and I wrote a piece of software that some guys from Lego saw, and they said, come in and do some work for us.
So, you know, Lego's been going for like 83 years altogether, and it's had a bit of a resurgence of late, as you will know if you have empty pockets like me. You will be getting hucked to buy Lego things to make things like this. What's this one, Ryan?
So we've got over here, we've got one of the roulettes from the RAAF, which is cool. This is actually designed to be hung from a toy store in formation. So there's six of the roulettes flying around. So some of them are upside down and all the rest.
So that would be your job then, to make things for the toy stores?
Yeah, that's predominantly what I do.
So right.
This one here though, this one's a bit of a personal project of mine. This is the Ferrari from the movie Ferris Bueller's Day Off. And I could never afford the real Ferrari, so I had to build my own.
How long did that take?
That took about 6 weeks to put together.
And do you let the kids in to help, or do you lock yourself in a room?
No, the kids, it's all about the kids. So, yeah, the kids are involved. Sometimes they end up a little bit different, but that's okay.
What about this? Now, this is something I reckon Stephen K. Amos will adore this.
So, we've got a bit of a take on Jetstar. Instead of Jetstar, we've got Star Wars, or the Death Star instead of Jetstar. And so all the characters from Star Wars are on board having a great time going on a holiday to the Gold Coast.
Quite extraordinary. So,
I've got to say, I absolutely love that.
And as I said, the figurines, there are 5 billion Lego figurines that have been made by Lego over since 2000 or 75, when they started making
75,
figurines.
75, that's right, spot on.
So that is the largest population of people in the world, the Lego figurine. Can you imagine?
They're going to wake up one day too.
So what we'll do is we'll come back to you, panel, and perhaps you can throw some suggestions to us so that Ryan can actually build you something. You reckon you can build anything?
Absolutely. Yeah, hand over the bricks.
I've got a request, please.
It all starts with a brick.
I've got a request. We were talking earlier about finding love as a single person. Could you make me a life-size Lego person?
Well, you know, funny you should say that, but I don't necessarily know whether the life-sized Lego person will have... Well, if you were writing a list, I actually think that the Lego person would just be perfect, because, quite frankly, how can you choose your love from a list? Yeah. Doesn't it just hit you splat in the face and then you think, what happened?
Yeah. Oh, well, look, we'll leave the challenge there for you, Libby. Hopefully you can deliver. And an interesting point about that, that the Lego Jetstar planet actually has more legroom than the real thing.